Okay, we're going to get started with prayer. We know that our nation was built on principles, leaders who believed in godly principles, who knew that there needed to be a plan in place for a country that was much bigger than we as simple human beings are. And we're going to do that even now. So if you don't mind, let's just quiet ourselves and let's commit our time to God and ask for His grace and His mercy on what we're doing. Heavenly Father, thank you for your grace and your mercy. Thank you for your great love for so many people all over the world, really. But thank you for what you have done to help us to accomplish bringing to light the challenges in our electoral process, in our elections, and helping us to sort through what we can do as citizens to help solve the problem of fairness and honesty in our elections. God, we just commit our day to you. We pray your kingdom authority over today. We pray your hand of blessing on us, and thank you again for all these wonderful, amazing people across California who have put so much time and energy into helping us do the kind of research that we need to get answers. And we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay, we're going to start also with the Pledge of Allegiance. We have a vet. Ruth, I'm going to hand this off to you so you can do an introduction here.
I'm really proud to introduce to you a friend of mine who he and his wife rearranged their entire schedule to drive all the way from San Diego, California to be here with us today. And Bob is a proud veteran, and we've asked if he will lead us all in the Pledge of Allegiance.
And I would ask all those that have honorably served in the military to render a hand salute as we pledge allegiance to our great flag and nation. Ready, begin. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all, too. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Bob. I'm going to take care of a little bit of housekeeping here today. For those of you who aren't aware of it yet, if you just walk right through the doors behind me and into the rotunda, you'll find restrooms there, very convenient for you. You will have to go through the screening, so try to leave a lot of your stuff outside. They'll just screen you to make sure you're not taking bad stuff in there, and then just you can do that, and it's right there, very easy to find. Also, let you know that it'll be warm out here today, and we have brought water for you. At that last table down there before the real colorful one, we have a lot of bottles of water. There is a cooler there, so if you're some of the first people to get there, you'll get a cold one. After that, it's going to be room temperature, but we'll try to keep them in the shade. So please help yourself and keep yourself hydrated if you should need some water. We also want you to visit our EIP hospitality tables. We have petitions to sign even up to the last minute. And so if you've not yet signed the petition, we'd love to have you add your name to the numbers of people that we later will take into Governor Brown to say, these are the voices you didn't listen to. We also have all of the information, the brochures and different information about EIP. If you need those, please take a copy. There's a donation bucket on each of those tables, a little blue hat in most cases, and there are some EIP pins and pads, so feel free to take a pin and a pad, and if you feel led, please leave us a little donation for that, and I think that takes care of just about that. The other thing I want to let you know is that we have invited all of the assembly people and the senators who voted with us on this bill. We have invited them to come here and to address you whenever they could get here today. They're very busy in the Capitol today. There are a lot of meetings going on, budget meetings, etc. But we do have a few who have indicated that they think they can squeeze out a few minutes. However, they couldn't identify exactly what time. So although we have an agenda we're going by, I'm from San Diego, California. We have a very interesting theater there. It's an outdoor theater called the Starlight Theater. And it's really an adventure to go to a play at Starlight because that open arena happens to sit directly in the flight path toward San Diego's Lindbergh Field. And at that point, those planes are very, very low because they're just about to land. You can imagine that you can't hear what's going on the stage when one of those planes goes over. So they have an ingenious thing that the actors can see from their stage in the back of the arena is a stoplight, a traffic light. And someone operates that. They can see a plane coming and they'll turn it to yellow so the actors know, okay, the plane's almost here. When it turns red, everything on the stage freezes. mid-sentence, mid-word, mid-dance, they freeze. Wait till the plane goes over and the sound interference is gone, and then they just take it right back up again as if nothing had happened. That's kind of what we're going to do here today. Doesn't matter what we're in the middle of, if we have one of our representatives find time to peek a nose out here and to speak a few words to you, we will stop what we're doing, give that person the microphone, and then we'll just move on with what we're doing. So we're really eager to have them here. When they do come, let's give them a real round of applause and a thank you for doing the right thing on this bill, even though they got outvoted. Okay, so I'm going to turn this now over to Linda, and she's going to get the party started. Linda, your turn. All right, good. Mike's going to give us a song before we do some more talking at you. Great.